años.
Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sahana Bhunaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvinavadhitamastu Ma Vidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shruti Smriti Purananam Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Padam Shankaram Loka Shankaram Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Veda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Pranamya Rama Abhinavatma Dhipadam Jagat Prasutisthiti Sanyamayanam Tadātmakān Shankara Pūrvakān Gurūn Mayopadeśārtha Vibhāga Ucchyate So the second paragraph explained mumukshunam, shraddhathanam, arthinam, arthaya, moksha sadhana upadesha dividim vyakhyasyamaha. We are now explaining the vidhi, the method of imparting the knowledge which is the means of the moksha to the mumukshus who are mumukshus, those who are seekers of moksha, shraddhadhanam, those who are possessed of shraddha and faith and devotion, arthinam, those who are desirous of moksha for their purpose. And that passage in turn was explained in detail in the second passage. And then the teacher was told. So the qualifications the student were given. What is mumukshunam, shraddhadhananam, arthinam? So these were the qualifications. These are the qualifications of the student. And for a student like that, bruyat acharyam shikshayati, that acharya, the teacher also should tell him. Meaning that, should impart him the knowledge, give him the upadesha. And punah punah bruyad, the teacher should teach him or give him instruction again and again, yavat grahanam dhri bhavati, until this knowledge becomes firm. Tika karate upadeshasya drishtarthatam abhipretyaha. Inasmuch as this upadesha produces drishtartha, an immediate result, evident result, because moksha is not to be attained in future, is to be attained here and now, because moksha is the nature of the self, and self is already existing, I am the self. meaning that I am mukta, I am liberated already, that's the reality about me. In this Upadesha, as we discover that reality about me. Therefore, it is like the tenth man who is told, you are the tenth man. So it's called Drishtartha. That the result is immediate, here, evident to us. And then the student would know whether he is liberated or not. And the teacher here will say that the teacher also would know whether the student has gained the knowledge. And until the teacher is satisfied, assured, confident that now the student has gained the knowledge, that he has gained that krita-krityata, the fulfillment which is the goal of life, until then he should keep on teaching the student. Meaning that the teacher must make sure that the disciple also has gained the fulfillment in life. Now continuing, the Tikakara says, evam ukta visheshanena shishyena guru pasaddhi karya. Ukta visheshanena shishyena. The shishya, the aspirant to the disciple who is possessed of, is not yet shishya. He is a mumukshu. So ukta visheshanena mumukshuna, by the mumukshu, by the aspirant, who possesses all these qualifications, that he is a vairagya virakta, sadhyat, sadhanat, sadhya, sadhanat, viraktaya. So, all one who enjoys the virakti. Samadama dayadi sampannaha, who possesses the inner qualities of samadama daya. And also possesses the external qualities that he belongs to a given caste, is a brahmana. So one who possesses all these ideal qualifications, what should that person do? Sadvidvan upasrupyatam. He must upasarpanam. He must necessarily approach a teacher. Evam ukta visheshanena shishyena guru upasatti karya. Karya means should be done. Guru upasatti means approaching the teacher. And so, an aspirant who possesses these qualifications then must necessarily approach the teacher, meaning that must necessarily take refuge unto the teacher. Should accept the teacher as his refuge, as his guide, as his protector, as his friend, philosopher, you know, and guide. Meaning that a guru should be there for an aspirant of this nature. So this is what this aspirant should do, karya. Guruscha tam upadishet vidyamiti. And the guru also has a role, I mean also sort of has a duty, that tam vidyam upadishet. To an aspirant like this, the guru should necessarily impart the knowledge. Iti ukte arthe shrutim udaharati. So Bruya, this was essentially said in the previous passage. To validate what was said in the previous passage, the shrutim udaharati, in the next passage now, the teacher presents a statement of shruti based upon which, so basically what is meant here is that whatever he said here, vidivat brashuchaye brahmanaya vidivas upasannaya shishyaya. So how do you say that the shri should necessarily approach the teacher? On what basis do you say? And parikshitaya bruyat punah punah. And to a disciple or aspirant who has been tested in this manner, the guru also should make all the effort to see that he gains the knowledge. So something on the part of the shishya, something on the part of the guru. So for that, ukterthe shrutim udaharati. So this is already stated what the aspirant should do and what the acharya should do. Shrutim udaharati, the author here now quotes the shruti the statement of the Upanishad. So now the next passage says, Shrutischa Pariksha Tattvato Brahma Vidya. So what is Pariksha Lokan Karma Chidan Brahmano Nirveda Mayat Nasti Kritah Kritena Tadvijnanartham Sagurumeva Abhigachet Samit Panahi Shrutriyam Brahmanishtam Tasme Savidvan Upasannaya Samyaka Prashanta Chittaya Shamanvitaya Yenaksharam Purusham Veda Satyam Provachatam Tattvato Brahma Vidyam. In fact, there are two mantras in Mundaka Upanishad which are here quoted. I mean, the text does not state them in their entirety, but this mantras are meant here. So these two mantras tell you. The first mantra says what the disciples should do. The second mantra says what the acharya should do. So pariksha lokan karma chitam brahmana nirvedamayat. Karma chitam lokan pariksha. That's what the Mundaka Upanishad says. Karma chitan karmana sampadidan. How a person should in fact take a stock of his life. At some point in time, when thus the mind becomes contemplative and it reflects upon the life, takes the stock of life. Karma chitan lokan pariksha. Karmana sampaditan lokan pariksha. The loka is what? Bhuhu, bhuvah, suvah. So karmana sampaditan, what can be attained by karma is something another than yourself. The anatma lokan characterized by this world, bhuvah, the middle world, and the suvah, the swarga. So these are all karma chitan loka, all of these are the loka, the worlds, the realms, or the sadhya, the ends which are attainable by karma. Dakshinottara marga gamyan karma phalabhutan. So, dakshina marga, uttara marga, these two marga are stated. That if you perform merely karma, then you go to the putra pitra loka. You karma upasana, you go to swarga loka. So dakshinayana, uttarayana. Karma phala bhutan, basically of the nature of karma phala, result of the karma actions and upasanas. Pariksha. So all these attainable realm, one should, and so this is in the Vedic terms. So in the time when this Upadesha was given, Mundaka Upanishad, this is what the people knew. What the Vedas tell you, what the possibilities of life are, and how to achieve those possibilities, by what kind of efforts or karma. So what was known at that time, in respect of that, this was stated. It should be translated these days now that what are the attainable things depending upon whatever Shraddha is. Because we no more believe in Swarga, etc. And so they don't entertain our life or our radar. In fact, the Swarga has no place. Some other things may have place. And so whatever a human being aspires to attain, examining that. Bhogya Padarthan, meaning that those can be enjoyed. Pariksha, one should examine them very well. Paritaha Iksha, examining them from all the sides. Shastra Anumanabhyam. What the Shastra says, just as the karma chado loka kshiyate, that just as what is attained by karma in this world ultimately is perishable, so also whatever one can attain the other world also is perishable. Shastra itself says that even Swarga also is perishable. And Brahma Bhuvana Loka, that all the worlds up to Brahma Loka also are returnable. Anumana Abhyam, and by Anumana also. Yat Kritakam Tadanityam, whatever is attained as a result of karma is impermanent. Anityatvena Nischitya. So this is what Upanishad says, that one should see this fact, that whatever is attainable, meaning whatever it is that is other than ourselves is attainable today or tomorrow, is anitya, is impermanent. Regardless of how great it is anitya. Brahmana adhikari purusha nirveda mayat. Ukta bhogya padarthebhya vairagyam ayat vairagya. One should discover vairagya. It is not only enough to recognize that whatever is attainable is impermanent, but important to recognize is that what I am seeking is permanent. That is more important. One should be aware or sensitive to what one is seeking. So what's the desire behind all the desires in my life is the desire for the permanent. That I cannot be satisfied with anything impermanent, however great that is. That I am seeking permanent. Seeking something that happiness that comes and doesn't go. But nothing whatever in this world or the other worlds is capable of giving me that. So, that's how vairagyam kuryat. One should now become dispassionate that this is not what I want. Or this is not the means of what I am seeking in life, therefore I don't need it. That viveka is firm, then vairagya also becomes firm. The idea is that the vairagya, the dispassion, is born of viveka, not from some experiences. Because an experience brings about some kind of reaction which is called vairagya, and it's temporary. Something happens, I give up everything. Then something else will happen and you will pick up everything also. Brahmana grahanam kshatriya vaishya upalakshanartham. This tikakara says Brahmana should include kshatriya and vaishya. But Acharya does not think so. Tayo api brahma vidyam adhikara darshanahat. So they said, when we see the scriptures and Purana, etc., then we find that other than Brahmanas also, there have been those aspirants who gained the knowledge brahma vidya, that they have been taught. And so, anyway, so vairagya prakaram. What's a vairagya prakaram? Nasti krita krutena akrutaha krutena karmana nasti. Akrutaha nityam brahma sruva mokshaha nasti. Akruta uncreated. So what can we... Permanent is that which is not created, because whatever is created is impermanent. So when I say that I am seeking the permanent in my life, that means that it was necessarily uncreated. And uncreated cannot be attained anyway, because whatever is attained is impermanent. Nitya brahma swarupa moksha nasti. Akruta is moksha. Moksha is the liberation, the freedom is uncreated, then only it can be permanent. And it is the nature of, that is Brahman, and that's the nature of the self, so that cannot be attained by karma or by an effort. Atah karanat tad vijnanartham. So this is next one. This insight that moksha is to be attained by knowledge. So far a person always was seeking to attain moksha, but now this viveka arises that it can be only attained by knowledge because it is permanent, meaning it is already existing, already attained, its attainment is attained. So this is a big transformation. As our Swami would say that when a person becomes jignyasu, from mumukshu, he becomes a jignyasu. From seeker of moksha, he becomes seeker of knowledge. So, ahankaradi dehantan bandhan ajnana kalpitam. All these bandha, all the bondages ajnana kalpitam. So, swarupa avodhen. So, therefore, by knowledge of one's own nature alone, that one can gain the liberation. Tadvijnanartham sa jata vigvairagya. This one who has now discovered the vairagya or dispassion, samit paanihi, samit pravrti upayana hastah san. He should, samit only need not be just the faggots, whatever else also you think that can be useful to the guru. Guru meva gachet. Upadeshtaram acharyameva gachet prapnuyat. He must necessarily go to the teacher for the knowledge. Nadu svayam dhiratva bhimanam kuryat. So one should not have this kind of notion that I can attain the knowledge by myself. There must be that humility arising from an understanding of reality that this knowledge must be gained from the teacher. So that's another insight. First insight is that what I am seeking is permanent. Second insight is that it can be attained only by knowledge. The third insight is that that knowledge must be gained from a competent teacher. And for that, I must surrender to the teacher, approach the teacher in a proper manner. Tathacha uktam vedantanam anekatvat samshayanam bahutvatah vedyasya piti sukshmatvat na janati gurum vina iti. He said vedantanam anekatvat, because Upanishads are many. In every Upanishad there is its own style. And to discover that all Upanishads in fact have same message, that tatparya is the same of all Upanishads is the same, is something only teacher can tell us. Because very often the Upanishad statements appear to be contradictory to each other also. Or as you have seen in Brahma Sutras, that a given statement of Upanishad also is sometimes subject or available for more than one interpretations. And so basically what is to be done is tatparya nirnaya, what it is that the Upanishads are teaching. And because Upanishads are many, and because their styles are different, and because the statements are subject to more than one interpretations, therefore, we require someone who can make us understand what is tatparya, the purport of these statements is. Samshayanam bahutvatah. And very often those statements of Upanishad create doubt that it means this or it means that. Vedyasya piri sukshmatvat. And Brahman, the self that is to be known, is subtler than the subtlest. It can be objectified. So Brahman or Atma is not something that can be objectified, verified in a laboratory, etc. And therefore, sukshmatvat. Na janati guru vina. For these reasons, one cannot gain the knowledge of the self without a guru. So this is why one should necessarily go to a teacher. What kind of guru? Shrutriyam brahmanishtam. Shrutram adhita veda vedartham. One who has studied the Veda and Vedartha, and meaning, you know. So text as well as meaning very well. Brahmanishtam brahmani nishthavantam. One who abides in Brahman. So, Brahma Jnani, now who is Brahma Jnani? So one should approach a teacher of that nature. So that whole vakya, and the next one says, so hitadva shishyaya se atabodhanam vasyam guna kartavyam. When an aspirant like that approaches you, then Guru should necessarily avasyam atmabodhanam. The Guru must necessarily impart the knowledge to him. So that is said in the next passage there, tasmai sa vidvan upasannaya samyak prashanda chittaya shamanvitaya. Tasmai saha vidvan, that Guru is vidvan, brahmavid, that wise Guru, samyak upasannaya shishyaya, the disciple who has very well properly approached him. I mean, with all humility, with the shraddha, with the faith, you can see that this is a very sincere and fit student. And you can see prashanda chittaya shamanvitaya, prashanda chittaya harshadi dosha rahita chittaya. You can see that this person enjoys an inner silence, inner quietude. There is no conflict in the mind. There is no inner conflict. He enjoys an inner peace, which is characterized by absence of reactions. Person doesn't react. Harshadi dosha rahitaya. You just react and you start. So something makes you so happy that again you go out of control. And the next moment you become sad, again you go out of control. So harsha and sukha both are reactions. And we lose ourselves in the reaction. And that means the person is shallow inside, doesn't have the depth inside, because only shallow thing will overflow again and again and dried up again and again. So harsha dosha rahita chittaya shamanvitaya bahyantara bahyant indriyuparam yuktaya. Both bahyantara, that he also is disciplined with reference to his conduct, with reference to the organ of perception, organ of action, he is complete control over all his faculties. So when we see that, so this is how the shishya is prashanda chittaya shamanvitaya, and Guru is what? Vidwan, the wise person. Tattvato veda sattvat veda tattvo brahma vidyam. To an aspirant like this, the brahma vidya must be taught as it is. Tattvato yathavat pravacha prabruyat. Pravacha should be interpreted as prabruyat. To an aspirant like this, the Guru must necessarily impart the knowledge yathavat as it is, without leaving anything residual. That Guru also must wholeheartedly teach, and not keep something under his desk or whatever. He should also openly share everything that he has. And he will. Looking at the aspirant like this, the Guru becomes so pleased that he is very happy to share. That is the Guru who enjoys sharing this. Right? So doesn't have a hesitation. After all, he will compete with me. He will also know everything that I know. Then what will happen? And this kind of stuff is not there. So, tattvato provacha yathavat prabruyat. And Guru also should teach him as it is and as he knows. So, what should he tell? Yatha yena aksharam purusham veda satyam. Yena means yaya brahma vidya aksharam. Yena means yaya brahma vidya, by brahma vidya, by which aksharam purusham satyam aksharam purusham veda, that the disciple comes to know the purusha, the paramatma. Aksharam immutable, satyam the unchangeless, truthful. Ukta shishya vijaniyat. And so this is also looks like a burden on the Guru. Yena aksharam purusham veda satyam. Yena, by which imparting the teaching, the disciple comes to know the aksharam purusham satyam veda. Gavich vijaniyat. Until the disciple comes to know that. Acharya sabhyam niyamaha yanyaya prapta shishyodhranam avidyabdehiti bhavaha. So looks like Upanishad also is giving a niyama. They say that wise person cannot be real. There cannot be any kind of vidhi or enjoyment. You can't ask him to do something and not do something because he's not available for vidhi nisheda. But still, the Upanishad says that it is a duty of an acharya like that, shishyodharanam, that he must lift the shishya, he must help him cross the ocean of avidya, avidyabdehe, that he must rescue him from the ocean of ignorance. This is what the teacher should do. So that is what is quoted here. So Tikakara says, Parikshalokan, Karmashitan, Brahmano, Nirvedamai, Devakramya, Yenakshanam, Purusham, Vedasatyam, Purvachatam, Tatoda Brahm, Itiantena, Granthen, Uktarthan, Nirupita, Hityardahan. Meaning that the previous passage already explained the meaning of this mantra. So what is said in the previous passage already explained the meaning of this mantra. So Shrutischa. So when the teacher says here that this is how the Shruti is, so means that in support of what we have stated, this is quoted here. Then Tikakara continues. Shishyasya dhruvagrahana paryantam guruna punah punar vidyopadeshtavya deshtavya etiyatra. Again also said that punah punah yavad grahanam drudi bhavati. So, shishyasya dhruvagrahana paryantam, until the shishya gains that knowledge firmly, until then, guruna punah punah vidya upadeshtavya, that guru should again and again, in one way or the other, continue the teaching, until the disciples gains a firmness of the knowledge. That also was stated in the previous passage. Ityatra hetumaha. So why did the previous passage say that this knowledge should be imparted by the teacher again and again until the disciples gains a firm understanding or firmly established knowledge until then, or firm understanding here, until then you should give this knowledge. Why is it so? So first of all, previous passage said how an aspirant should approach the teacher and how the teacher should impart knowledge. So that now this passage says that this is based on this statement of the Upanishads. And why did the passage number 2, earlier passage, said that the teacher should impart the knowledge until it becomes firm? So that reason is given here. So let us read the passage here. Dhruda grahita hi vidya Atmanaha Shreyase Santatyai Cha Bhavate. So, the only when knowledge is firmly grasped, Dhruda Grahita hi Vidya. Vidya, the knowledge, Dhruda Grahita, when it is firmly grasped, firmly received, meaning firmly understood and assimilated. Atmana Shreyase Santatyai Cha Bhavati. So there are two purposes here. Why should the teacher make sure that this disciple is understood? Kachidedachutam partha tvai kagrena chedasa kachidajnana sammoha pranashaste dhananjaya. Even Lord Krishna asks Arjuna, Re Arjuna, has your delusion gone? Have you gained that knowledge? to make sure that Arjuna has firmly grasped what is being taught. Nastoha smriti labdha. So Arjuna also confirms that my moha is gone and my knowledge has been gained. That serves two purposes. One is vidya atmana shreyase bhavati. Then although it can atmana shreyase for the good of one's own self, meaning that the knowledge blesses the self only when it is clearly and firmly grasped. There must be clarity in the knowledge as well as the firmness in knowledge. What is meant by firmness is that it is knowledge now that rules my life. That I am not overwhelmed by my past samskaras of avidya and therefore that knowledge is compromised. That now the person lives that knowledge. Then only there is shreyas, then only it is conducive to once the real good is, or the real well-being is when I live in keeping with the knowledge. Meaning that I live as I am. But the knowledge is nothing but revealing the truth of myself, that I am Brahman, or that I am already whole and complete. Etat buddhva buddhiman syat kruta krutyasya bharatat. I am already fulfilled, there is nothing to be done. So then as a fulfilled person, then I conduct myself. So in fulfillment alone there is shreyas. The well-being in our life is only when we attain the fulfillment in life. Atmaneva atmanatushta. When one is totally satisfied by oneself, with oneself. So that is called atmana shreyase bhavati. So this is conducive to the real well-being for the self, for one who gains that knowledge. So primary purpose is to that the person is blessed. Teacher blesses the disciple by making sure that the disciple gets the knowledge as he should. Then only there is a real well-being or shreyas in the life. And secondly, santyatyaiche bhavati. And also, then it can be transmitted. So who can transmit the knowledge to someone else? One who has understood it correctly and firmly. That person alone can transmit. So the teacher also warns that this knowledge be transmitted. That the disciple should really, he should feel fulfilled. And secondly, he should also become an instrument in transmitting this knowledge. Santatyaiche bhavati. Why should that transmission of knowledge be there? Then the passage continues. Vidya santatischa prani anugrahaya bhavati nauhu iva nadim titirshoho. Shastram cha yadyapi asmai imam advih parigrihitam dhanasya purnam dadyat etadeva tato bhuya ite. So vidya santatischa, number one, atmana shreyase bhavati, this knowledge also becomes conducive for a proper transmission of knowledge. Vidya santatischa, and the transmission of the knowledge also. Prani anugrahaya bhavati is for anugraha, for the well-being of prani, for the well-being of human beings. The knowledge is only the prerogative of human beings. So ultimately this knowledge is conducive to the well-being of the human beings, the people at large. That real well-being in life can only come with this knowledge. Until then there is ignorance, and when there is ignorance there can be true well-being. So true well-being can be only when the cause of any kind of suffering goes away, and that's ignorance. So vidya santatischa prani anugrahaya bhavati. It is for the anugraha, for the help or for the well-being of the people. It's a blessing to the people. It is the anugrahadi, so it becomes real blessing to the people. For that the example is given. Now who even Nadim Titisho. No means a boat, like a boat for a person who wants to cross the river. So what is it that is for the what is conducive to the well-being of a person who wants to cross the river, a boat? And so also for a person who wants to cross the ocean of samsara, then this knowledge is like the boat. Shastram cha. The Shastra also says that. Yadyapi asmai imam adbhi praigrihitam dhanasipunam dadyat. That this knowledge is not, cannot be compensated by anything. We'll see in Chandogya it is said, how can there can be no compensation of this knowledge? Said that although one may give to the teacher this world, the whole earth surrounded by water, that by ocean, the whole earth, not only whole earth, dhanasya purnam, full of riches, the whole earth characterized by being surrounded by ocean, and that is full of riches, even the whole thing is given in compensation of this knowledge, then also, etadeva tato bhuyah, this knowledge is even greater than that. Meaning there is nothing that can compensate this knowledge. So how do you bring about the welfare of people? Even the wealth also cannot bring about the ultimate welfare of the people. The ultimate welfare of well-being is only by this knowledge. So let us look at that part in the Tika. Shishyasya duragrahana paryantam guruna punah punah vidya upadeshtavya ityatra hetumah duragrahita hete atmanashreyah avidyadi dosha samsara nivrutte santatihe Shishya Pashishyade Sancharena Vidyayaha Avichedaha. So Guruna Punah Punah Upadeshtavya, this knowledge should be passed on or should be transmitted or communicated by the Guru again and again. So Dhruva Grahita, only when the Vidya is well grasped, clearly understood, as well as one has gained also a conviction, a firm conviction about this knowledge, about one's own self. Knowledge means what? A firm conviction about who I am. And when I realize who I am, then I realize what everything else is also, because I alone is everything. What I am is what everything is. So that's the beauty. That all you need to do is to know who I am, and once I is known correctly, then everything else is also known correctly as well. Atmani shrute mate vijnate, so drishte shrute mate vijnate, sarvidam vijnatam syat. He says, when you know the Atma, you as well know everything. So Mahatma said that if you want to love everything, love yourself. Know everything, then if you want to know everything, know yourself. If you want to attain everything, attain yourself. So everything ultimately boils down to one's own self. When there is clarity about oneself, because the self is the truth of everything, the idea is that what I call self is really the truth of everything. And that's the reason why knowing the self is essentially knowing the truth of everything. Therefore, ఆత్మన సో ప్రాణి అనుగ్రహసో ఆత్మన శ్రేయసే సంత ఆత్మన శ్రేయసే భవతి ఆత్మశ్రేయ అవిద్యాది దోష సంసార నివృత్తి. సో నివృత్తి ది ఎలిమినేషన్ ఆఫ్ సంసార విచ్ ఇస్ ది ప్రోడక్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది ఆల్ ది డిఫెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ అవిద్య. సంతత్యే చ భవతి సంతతి శిష్య ప్రశిష్యాది సంచారేణ విద్య అవిచ్ఛేద. దెన్ వాస్ వి కంటిన్యూటీ ఆఫ్ యు నో ది ట్రాన్స్మిషన్. దట్స్ వై లార్డ్ కృష్ణ సెడ్ సేవాయం సో సకాలేనే మహత యోగో నష్ట పరంతప. హే పరంతప, దిస్ యోగ ఆర్ దిస్ ట్రెడిషన్ అల్టిమేట్లీ వాజ్ లాస్ట్ ఇన్ అబ్సెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ది రైట్ పీపుల్. సో వెన్ ది రైట్ teachers and their disciples both were not there, so there must be also a vakta and shrota, both must be competent. In absence of the competent vakta and shrota, Lord Krishna says that this knowledge was essentially lost, the continuity was lost, the succession was lost, and therefore it is not available to people. And without this knowledge there cannot be true well-being in life. That's the reason why, hey Arjuna, today I have imparted that knowledge, same knowledge to you. So, shish santati shishya prashishyadi sancharena. Shishya and prashishya. So, disciple and disciple's disciple. So, that is why in Vedas, not only is it the duty of a householder to have a progeny son, but also a grandson. So, prajatischa, not only prajanascha, swadhyaya pravachane, prajatischa, swadhyaya. So you must make sure that your son also has a son, you know. So that means that santati must continue. There should not be the interruption in this succession of the father and son also. But then only all the culture can be passed on, you know, then only dharma can be passed on. Because father is the means of passing on the dharma and everything to the son, parents to the children. If therefore there is an interruption there, then this whole process will be interrupted, and therefore the next generation will be deprived. So present generation is deprived of all the culture, you know, because parents themselves do not know. So what can they pass on to their children? So shishya prashishyadi sancharena vidya avichedaha, an interruption. Vicheda is interruption, an interruption of the vidya, of the knowledge, by shishya prashishyadi sancharena, by transmission from guru to shishya and to his shishya and so forth. By this transmission, there is the uninterruption of this succession of the teacher and the student. Vidya santate ko upayoga hai tikaga, then dikagara says, Vidya santate ko upayoga ityatra aha vidya iti. So vidya santate ko upayoga, where is the usefulness of the santati, continuity of this knowledge? What's the usefulness of the continuity of this knowledge of succession of teacher and the disciple? So said vidya santatischa prani anugrahaya bhavati. The teacher said that the transmission of the knowledge or continuity of this knowledge is for the well-being of the society. Society at large. How nohu even nadim titirshoho, just as a boat is the means of well-being, anugraha, a blessing for the person who wants to cross the river, so also this knowledge is a blessing to the people at large. So Tikagana says, yatha naditaranaya tatra ప్రవిష్టస్య అగాధే నిమజ్జతః నరస్య పారం ప్రాపయితుం నౌహు ఉపస్థాప్యతే కృపారుణా తథా samsara sagare nimajjatah praninah uddharanena tatparam vishnoho paramam padam prapaitam vidyasantana samrakshanam ityarthah. So important that this continuity of the knowledge also should be there, then only the people at large can be blessed. And this is the only thing that can bless the people. Just so crossing the river, only boat can bless, nothing else. So, yatha nadi taranaya tatra pravishtasya. A person wants to cross the river. He has entered the river. Agade nimajjataha, but he discovers that the river is very, very deep. And therefore he is drowning, nimajjataha. So he is submerged in the water, he doesn't know what to do. Narasya param prapayadum. To help this person cross that river, nauhus upasthapyade kripaluna. Some compassionate person comes forward and presents a boat before him. So here it is, here is a means of crossing the water. Now, why should somebody do the Krupaluna? It's only out of compassion that this person comes to help. So, there in Chandogya said that this person is left by the thieves in the midst of the forest with his eyes blindfolded and with his hands tied behind himself and so helpless. So, some compassionate person comes along and releases his bonds and guides him as to his destination where he wants to go. to the place from where he has come. So, Krupaluna. So, similarly, this Krupal, this compassionate person, sees that he is the person who is drowning in the deep water of the river and in a great need, he wants to cross that water and therefore presents a boat before him. Tatha samsara sagari nimajjataha praninaha. So similarly also prani who is drowning in the ocean of samsara. Uddharena tatparam vishno param mampadam prapayitam. So similarly also, what is the other shore of the samsara? What is the other shore of this? The ocean of ignorance, knowledge. And what is that goal? Tad padam vishno, tad padam paramam padam, tad vishno paramam padam. The supreme abode of the Vishnu, of Lord Vishnu. So, however you describe that abode, but it's the nature of the Vishnu, knowing Vishnu, but it's called the supreme abode, tad vishno paramam padam, the supreme abode of Lord Vishnu. So that is what obtains at the other end of this ocean of samsara. And this is where this fellow wants to reach. The only way is to present him with a boat with which he can cross that ocean of samsara. And so, what is that boat? Vidya santana samrakshanam. So it becomes also the duty of the teacher to make sure that this continuity also is retained. The reason why he makes sure that the disciple has firmly grasped his knowledge is because then only the disciple is competent to pass on this knowledge to his disciple. And that's the only way that the succession and thus the continuity will be retained. Only when there is continuity of transmission of this knowledge that it will reach to people who are in dire need of this knowledge. And so then, this santati, even this whole tradition itself becomes like a boat. It makes available the boat to the needy people, boat of knowledge to the needy people, boat or raft of knowledge sometimes you call it. Then again Tikakara says, Purvokta Shishya Guna Sampannaya parikshitaya vidvat upasannaya eva vidyadeya naitha katanchit praptaya dhanadilobhadva iti guroho niyamartham shruti shasanam udaharati shastram cha iti. So then, shastram cha, in fact, shastram cha means this, the shastra is also says how santati should be retained, but that chakara doesn't apply that way. When you say shastram cha, that means that now whoever nadim titir shoho, shastram cha, but the next sentence doesn't tell you that, it says something else. So, tikakara says, purvokta shishya guna sampannaya. So one who is shuchuchaya, brahmanaya, etc. So one who possesses all these the qualifications of a disciple, parikshitaya, and who has been very well examined by the teacher with reference to is what is it is vidya and the karma and the abhijana, etc. So one who is examining vidvat upasannaya, and again with all the humility and the devotion and the faith, this aspirant is approached as teacher. Vidyadaya, only to a competent person, a fit person, this knowledge will be imparted. Na yatha kathanchit praptaya. This should not be given to somebody who has just appeared. So people don't know, you know, they just... So, Swamiji, can I stay here? Can I learn this, etc.? You know, so, yatha kathanchit praptaya. Somehow he just appears there, you know. And meaning that you don't, it's not the formality that is important. It looks like that the text is emphasizing that the aspirant should appear in a formal manner or a prescribed manner. Is not the prescription that is important. Well, the prescription shows an attitude. When a person approaches you, the manner in which the person approaches also reveals the attitude. That he comes and stands there and does this and something, you know, so then you know the casual attitude is there. So this cannot be given to somebody who's casually come there, who has not discovered a value for the knowledge, or even if he has discovered a value, not discovered a value for the teacher, or not discovered a value for a proper relationship between the teacher and the student. So teacher may be valuable, knowledge, but then relationship must be there. That's very important. That this knowledge can be transmitted correctly or effectively only when there is a proper relationship established between the teacher and the student. So, tad viddhi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya. So, Lord Krishna said, establish the relationship with the teacher. Establish a bond with the teacher. And win over his heart. That's what is meant there. So, tad pranipatena, that long and prostration shows that he has this openness, he has this devotion, he has the faith and the trust in sevaya, and he serves the teacher. Because it is important. He realizes that this is what is going to help me. It is for my own sake that I am doing it. So all these attitudes are very important. Only when the right attitude is there on the part of the listener, then only this will be transmitted, not otherwise. It's not an objective science. You don't require all these qualifications for teaching in physics and chemistry, because what is all these things? You know, they don't insist upon any of these qualifications when you go to universities. You don't. For objective sciences, you don't require these attitudes because something is verifiable. Basically, what is required is an intellectual transmission from the professor to the disciple, that professor addresses the intellect of the disciple and he makes him see that, makes him understand. And the disciple also, the student also can verify in a laboratory, etc. So it's objective sciences, and also there is no emotion involved here. with reference to when I want to study physics or chemistry, meaning when the subject, when the what I want to study something different from me, I have no axe to grind, I have no emotional investment at all, or emotional involvement at all with the particle, with whatever, the chemical or, you know, something that I want to study. And my mind is open because I have no insistence upon how it should be. Here emotion is involved. Because you are the most emotionally attached to yourself. We are essentially emotionally attached to ourselves, and therefore our ideas, our conclusions, all that is all ego. So here, since emotion is involved of the disciple, therefore emotional relationship also is important, because then only he can set at his own conclusions. Because we are even identified with our own conclusions. So when somebody dismisses our conclusion, it is as good as dismissing ourselves, we get hurt. So when somebody proves that my understanding is wrong, it's not only understanding I am wrong, and that hurts me. So therefore, an emotional person is involved here. In a university setup, only an intellectual person is involved, not an emotional person. Here, an intellectual as well as emotional person is involved. And emotions being subjective, is not tangible thing, they require certain attitude. That kind of emotion is required. So your attitude also is very important. Attitude that the student has toward the teacher and vice versa. So, na yatha kathanchit praptaya. It is not to exclude people that all these qualifications are said. It is only to make sure that this is transmitted to the right person, then only it will be received and then only it will be transmitted. Otherwise, if you give it to wrong person, even though in fact Virochana approached properly, I mean, you know, Virochana also, Vidhivas Upasanna, he was also, he approached the teacher properly and then he also performed penance for 32 years, but he was not ready. That Shamadama Daya also may not be there, and its Vairagya would not, was not there. And therefore he was ready to go back. So Anubhuti Prakashakara explained that the reason why Indra and Virochana could not grasp, because they were not willing to further deliberate upon that. They were quite happy with what they were told. It was okay, we are happy, because they were eager to go back. So by 32 years now, that the their home and their kingdom and all of that have already become important to them. So they want to finish this off and go home. That is the reason why they did not deliberate further on that at that time. So with all that stuff, it doesn't work. Then I have 6 months here, or 1 year, this much time I have, and this is what I have. That's kind of, it must be a dedication for the lifetime. No other agenda at all. That disciple also has no other agenda. And he has nobody else in his mind also, because there are not million gurus also. That's also a problem. Because you can't have more than one person in your heart. That's also, you can respect everybody. Ishta Devata is one, then you can respect other devatas like Panchayatana Puja, etc. But it's difficult to keep more than one in the heart. You can't have the same kind of bond, the feeling for everybody. But anyway, so that is the reason why it's not the upachara or the formality that is important. All that formality is described for which reveals certain right attitude and preparations. So niyatha katanchit praptaya, to the teacher also should not be too eager, you know, to pass on this knowledge. So they said, so when all Brahmacharya Diksha is given, then even the one suspectful, you know, he says, when you find somebody, you suspect that this fellow can know, right away attack him, you know. Meaning that you go and do, this is all the mission work, you know, prachar work. That the idea was that you spread this knowledge to the masses, you know, spread it. Okay, that's good. But the thing is that is whether it helps them or hurts them, and what it is, you don't know. If they come up with all these wrong notions, then it's all mithya. Usme kya hai, Swami? It's all mithya. So, I mean, after all, what's wrong with watching TV? What's wrong with doing this? It's mithya after all. So, people just, all kinds of justifications are given by people. So, you don't know. When the mind is not ready, how it will be used, how this particular teaching will be used, you never know whether it will help the person or hurt the person. Dhanadi lobhadva, or teacher also, should not come under the influence of the dhanam or the wealth, the gain that will be there, that if I impart this knowledge, he's an important person, then he'll give me this donation and stuff like that. Any kind of consideration is all wrong, you know. So, no, this cannot be. There can be no agenda at all. On the part of teacher, the only agenda is how to make the student see, gain that knowledge. That's the only agenda. And the student is only one agenda, how to get the knowledge. That's all, nothing else. If anything else enters this, then it's going to pollute this whole process. That's why. So to keep it, to keep the dignity and the purity of this, this is a very important thing. This is a very sacred thing, in fact, that the teacher is imparting Brahma Vidya to a disciple is something very rare, very sacred. And that is why all care must be taken to maintain the dignity, maintain the sanctity. And that's why so much is said about the qualification of disciple and qualification of teacher and all the attitudes. It's not for no reason. So it may look to us that all these orthodox people, they want to exclude everybody else and they are only, you know, by describing elaborately the qualification of disciple, they want to exclude everybody else. Basically, the idea is to maintain the dignity, the sanctity of this whole process. Dhanadi lobhadva, there should not be that this is not given because there is some lobha, some hidden gain of so dhanam, dhanadi. So either you want some wealth or a labha, puja, khyati, etc. And so some kind of a gain, some respect, some, you know, khyati means fame, etc. None of that should be consideration at all. Iti guruho niyamartham. So, guru also has this niyama. They don't just be too eager to pass on to anybody and everybody who comes to you and have no agenda other than simply the well-being of the person to whom you are imparting this knowledge. Guruho niyamartham. Shruti shasanam udaharati. And so, shruti shasanam. What the shruti in fact commands, what the shruti directs, enjoins, is being quoted here, Shastram Chaiti. So this statement comes from Chandogya Upanishad. So Tadidat, having imparted this whole knowledge, this was of course in the context of Upasana in the Chandogya Upanishad. So this was the Madhu Vidya. In the context of Madhu Vidya, when we were told that the Aditya, the sun, is like a honeycomb, you know, and how the madhu or the nectar is brought into by the various honeybees, etc., and how the rays are radiating and blessing the whole world. So that Madhu Vidya is a very, very important Vidya, and there is Tadetat Brahma Prajapataye Uvacha. There also the succession was told that Brahma imparted this Madhu Vidya to Prajapati. Prajapatir Manave, Prajapati to his son Manu. Manu Prajabhya, and then Manu in turn imparted knowledge to the people at large. Tadetat Undalakaya Arunaye Jeshthaya Putraya Pita Brahma Provacha. Uddalaka Aruna, who is the eldest son, to whom this Brahma, this knowledge was passed on by the father. Idam vavada jeshthaya putraya pita brahma prabruyat. that may the father impart this knowledge to his eldest son. Pranayaya va antevasine. Pranayaya so yogyaya antevasine shishyaya. So either it should be given to the son or a fit antevasi or disciple. Nanyasmai kasmai chanayadi. So nanyasmai kasmai chanayadi. There is not to anybody and everybody that this knowledge will be imparted. Then he said, yadyapi asma imam adbhi parigrahitam dhanasya puranam dadyat etadeva tato bhuyaiti etadeva tato bhuyaiti. So this Madhu Vidya is now concluded with the statement that yadyapi kaschidapi acharya imam prithivim adbhi parigrahitam samudra pariveshitam samastamapi dhanasya dhanena bhogopakarani puranam sampannam dadyat. If somebody comes along and offers to the teacher a whole earth filled with all the riches, tathapi etadeva madhu vidyadanava tato yathokta prithividanat bhuyaha. So this dhanam, meaning that this imparting of this knowledge, that's all the vidya dhanam. So the teacher is doing dhanam or is offering or giving this vidya, madhu vidya. Can there be any dhanam, can there be any charity that can compensate? There's nothing that can compensate the transmission of this knowledge. The most they can think of is a whole earth full of all the riches. That's the maximum that one can give. Even that also cannot compensate for this knowledge, because this is more valuable than anything. Because after all, this wealth can only bring about the well-being as far as your mortal life is concerned at the most. But this is to make you free from mortality. So no amount of wealth can make you free from mortality. This amrutam, this makes you free from mortality altogether. So how can there be any compensation? So therefore, this shows the value of the knowledge, and that's the reason why it should be, it's a very valuable, most valuable it is. So Tikakara says, Niyamakam cha niyamakam shastram cha atraste ityarthah. Then with reference to this, there is also the statement of the scripture. Tadeva aha yadyapite. So this is quoted from the Upanishad. Imam prasivim adbih parigrahitam samudra pariveshtitam dhanasya purnam vittena upachitam dadyat kaschida yadyapi tathapi naetad darshanam tasme dadyat yataha etata tataha vitta purna prasavi dhanadapi bhuyah adhikataram iti yojana. Same thing, imam, even the whole earth, adbhi parigrahitam, that which is surrounded by water or the oceans, dhanasya purnam, and then the wealth that is overflowing, you know, wealth. So upachitam, vitten upachitam. So that possesses plenty of this wealth. If somebody makes an offer like this, tathapi etad darshanam tasmina dadyat, even then darshanam, meaning this upasana, in this case vidya, should not be given to him. Why yataha etat tataha vitta purna prasvi dana ve bhuya adhikataram, because this is even greater in value than the value of the whole earth filled with riches. Tikagara says, Nahi akashade samasta bhuta bhautika adhishthanasya tatopi adhikatarasya aparichinnasya brahmanah dānasya idam anurupam iti bhavah. So dānam that the teacher is making to a disciple is much greater. Akashadi samasta bhuta bhautika adhisthanasya. Where is the Prithvi? Earth is just one, you know, you're talking the whole universe. Akashadi samasta bhuta bhautika adhisthanasya brahman. So this is the knowledge about Brahman, which is adhisthanam, the substratum. Not only of the Prithvi, but then all the whole universe consisting of the space, all elements beginning from space and all elementals, so which they make up this universe, that is adhisthanam, substratum of this whole universe. Tatopi adhikatarasya. Adhisthanam is always great. That's called adhisthanam, adhikasthanam. So that which enjoys a greater place or greater value than what is superimposed. So Brahman is adhisthanam, so substratum of the whole universe and therefore greater than the whole universe. Aparichinnasya brahmana dānasya. It's dānam, the charity or giving of Brahman, which is limitless. Na idam anurupam. Even this giving of the earth, etc., is not anurupam, not in keeping with the, does not compensate the dānam of the vidya. Tatha ca śrutihi pādasya viśvā bhūtāni tripādasya mṛtam divi iti. So śruti says pādasya viśvā bhūtāni. All the bhūtāni, all the elements, the entire universe is only one quarter of this Brahman. Tripadasya amrutam devi. And so, amrutam tripadasya devi, this immortal, the 3 feet of the Brahman. So, 1 foot, 1 quarter of Brahman covers the whole universe. The 3 quarters is immortal. You can say 1 quarter is a mortal universe, so the one universe is born and sustained and dissolved in 1 quarter of the Brahman. But 3 quarters are immortal in Divi, transcending. So Brahman is a transcendental reality, and this Vishwa is what superimposed upon that. And therefore, what is superimposed can never, ever, you know, compensate for or compare with that which is transcendental substratum. And so this is how it should not be imparted to anybody, because this is the most valuable thing that can be, and therefore one must make sure that the one who is going to receive this knowledge also deserves the valuable gift that the teacher makes him. So teacher makes a gift to the disciple, and that is of the most valuable thing. And it is given free, for no compensation from the disciple. Except that the disciple must be a deserving one, so deserves receiving this gift. That's what the teacher should make sure. That's what is meant here. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah. Hari Om.